Hello everyone, Dr. Benadusi here. In this video, I'll show you how to identify the cranial nerves in two different models. And before I start, I would like to remind you that you must use Roman numerals when you're referring to cranial nerves. Throughout the years, I noticed that the easiest way for students to remember the position of the cranial nerves is by using their hands. So let's go ahead and do it. You position your hands like this, and in the hand that you will start counting, you put the middle finger on top of the index finger, and in the other hand, you put them right next to each other. Then you start counting. Cranial nerve number 1, 2. Cranial nerve number 3 is on top of cranial nerve number 4. Cranial nerve number 5 is the big one, trigeminal. Very easy to identify. So if the cranial nerve number 5 is the E1 that's big and it's easy to identify, you look for something that's close to the midline, medial, for cranial nerve number 6, abducens. Then you have cranial nerve number 7 right next to cranial nerve number 8. Then you have cranial nerve number 9. Cranial nerve number 10 is vagus. Vagus starts with the letter V, so you will draw a letter V. You have cranial nerve number 10. 11 and 12. You'll draw a letter V. Now, you will keep your hands like this while I am explaining the model, and you'll see that these will match to what we see in the model. It always goes from anterior to posterior. Here we have cranial nerve number 1. Then here we have cranial nerve number 2. If you follow your hand streak, you remember that you have cranial nerve number 3 and cranial nerve number 4 right below it. So here you have cranial nerve number 3 and here you have cranial nerve number 4. Now, cranial nerve number 5 is the big one, trigeminal. Trigeminal has 3 branches. We have the ophthalmic, maxillary, and mandibular branches. So these are the 3 trigeminal branches: the ophthalmic branch, the maxillary branch, and the mandibular branch. And this is the order they appear in the model. And you can say branch or division. So this is the trigeminal we just identified. After the trigeminal, we have number 6, abducens, right? If trigeminal is the big one, very easy to identify, number 6 will be medial. Number 6, number 7, this here is number 8, and you remember based on the hand streak, number 7 and number 8, they are right next to each other. Then you have a number 9, number 10 is vagus. It starts with the letter V, so you go number 10, all this is number 11, and here you have number 12. So 9, 10, 11, and 12. Looking on this side, you have here trigeminal, the big one. Right here, you have abducens, medial. Then you have number 7 and number 8. Then number 9. Here is number 10, is vagus. It starts with the letter V, so you go number 10, 11, and here you have number 12. Now we'll do the same thing, but I'll be telling you the name of the nerves. Here we have cranial nerve number 1, olfactory nerve. Here we have cranial nerve number 2, optic nerve. Here you have cranial nerve number 3, oculomotor nerve. And below you have the cranial nerve number 4, which is the trochlear nerve. Then we have cranial nerve number 5, trigeminal nerve, which has the 3 branches, the ophthalmic division, maxillary division, and the mandibular division. Medial, we have abducens, cranial nerve number 6, abducens nerve. Then you have cranial nerve number 7, facial nerve. Cranial nerve number 8, vestibulocochlear nerve. Cranial nerve number 9, we have the glossopharyngeal nerve. Cranial nerve number 10, vagus nerve. Cranial nerve number 11, accessory nerve.
And finally, we have cranial nerve number 12, which is the hypoglossal nerve. So here we have a different model, and you also need to identify the cranial nerves in this model. If you look here, we have, using your hand trick, it will be the same thing. You have number 3 and 4 on top of each other, and number 7 and 8 right next to each other, okay? So this is cranial nerve number 1. Here you have cranial nerve number 2. This part that you see here in between, right here, this would be the optic chiasm. Cranial nerve number 3 is this one. And cranial nerve number 4 is this one. So 3 and 4, they are on top of each other. It's just it's a different angle, so basically you need to squeeze it and you'd see that it would be literally on top of each other. Do not get confused with this little ball you see here. This is a mammillary body. It's not a nerve, okay? So this is cranial nerve number 2, and here is number 3. This is nothing about the cranial nerves. So cranial nerve number 3, cranial nerve number 4, cranial nerve number 5 is the big one, trigeminal, which means that the medial one will be abducens. After number 6, cranial nerve number 6, you have cranial nerve number 7, cranial nerve number 8, which are right next to each other. Cranial nerve number 9, you cannot see in this model because it would be deep there. So you don't see cranial nerve number 9. Here you have cranial nerve number 10, vagus, which starts with the letter V. So you have cranial nerve number 10, here is number 11, and here is number 12. So you go like a letter V. Cranial nerve number 11, it has two roots you guys will learn in lecture, that it has a cranial root and a spinal root. So basically right here is when you have the delimitation of where the spinal cord would start, because this is a spinal root. Now, let's do it again, telling the name of the nerves. And you can see here that all the cranial nerves, they run in pairs, right? You have the right and the left side. So, cranial nerve number 1, olfactory nerve. Cranial nerve number 2, optic nerve. Cranial nerve number 3, oculomotor nerve. Cranial nerve number 4, trochlear nerve. Cranial nerve number 5, trigeminal nerve. Cranial nerve number 6, abducens nerve. Cranial nerve number 7, facial nerve. Cranial nerve number 8, vestibulocochlear nerve. Cranial nerve number 9, you can't see, is the glossopharyngeal nerve. Cranial nerve number 10, vagus nerve.
Cranial nerve number 11, the accessory nerve. And cranial nerve number 12, the hypoglossal nerve.